Robbin, in the world of Robbin Baskin, being a vanilla scoop in the world of Robbin Baskin. ToastMaster Shobhit. Thank you.
So, good evening, Toastmasters. Did you count the difference of voice as per my objectives? Because I was covering the spectrum of all audience with respective amount of energy. So I hope you all keep your energy level to the one I spoke at the last. That was a scripted act from my side to cover my objectives. Sorry. So today I'm gonna share you my life experiences. It's not a world championship speech contest. So don't expect a lot, but accept a lot. Funding is very nice. So there is a reservation in our inside heart. Reservation has digged out our inside nerve of the brain. In every decision you take, there is a quota. 1% home state quota. Home is your heart, where the arteries and veins flow across. And 99% is others, influenced by others. Theory of relativity. Relatives, they are making you to suffer from the time due to what they could not do in their life. There is a reservation. And only 1% of the human beings have succeeded somehow to do what they wanted. So I will tell you a few stories that you could be in those 1%, especially the first year who have just arrived on this pedestal of IIT college. So I want to share the title of me, Be a Vanilla Scoop in the World of Baskin Robbins. I don't watch Game of Thrones, I'm not fond of TV series. Yeah, as I also watch Coffee with Karan. I've not watched Secret Games, I've not watched many TV series. Yes, I have a right to live. I can also pray. I have the right to speak and I am speaking now. So why to discourage some segment of people? Because they are not like you. Have you considered yourself as a character? You all are human bank. You have a repository of emotions. Every person you meet, they invest some emotions, leave zero balance of 15% amount. Whenever you break up, that 15% of emotions are the leftover and you feel suffering for that 15% emotion. This is what happens with 99%. They are influenced by others. When they leave out, they feel suffering and they feel break up from the emotion. But what these other 1% do? They have transparency in their heart. They choose to what they wanted. They have a zero balance account. You come, you meet me, your work is done. I am honest, I am truthful. There will be professional transparency and a personal domain. There is a clear dichotomy between this. And one of the dichotomy was displayed by KFC founder, Kentucky Fried Chicken founder, Colonel Sanders. He was at the age of 6, his father died. At the age of 7, mother died. At the age of 8, sister died. It was like a Vyapam Bhuta, everything was dying. So he was very unique. When at the age of 16, he quit alcohol and drugs. And you might be thinking KFC founder is having so much of problems. He would have been bankrupted financially and emotionally. And yes, he was. At the age of 21, he got married, he got a son, and then he got a divorce. So KFC founder was totally devastated in a whole scenario. And what he did next? He started to act as a lawyer. He was failed. He opened a startup of local burger. He failed. He was trying to join the army. Americans were not smart. They rejected him. Then he started to work as a dishwasher, as a vegetable vendor. He was a multitasking guy in a small business domain. And you will be surprised, at the age of 65, KFC founder was retired. He got a $105 reimbursement from the American Society, considering him unable to earn after he retires. So what happens was, he took $85 out of $105 for cooking. Because all of his life, KFC founder did just cooking in a small shop. He tried and experimented because he could not do earlier. He was about to suicide, but someone wrote, you cook very well. So he chose to be in those 1% home state quota and chose to do what he wanted. He did not see the other guy. He was not influenced by the critics. He was the own Taran Adarsh. And he started making burgers. And at the age of 88, KFC was what it is today. So KFC is not a piece of, it's not a cherry that has been alluring you for so many years. It is because of his efforts, persistence. Second story, that is my favorite, of Chinese President Jinping. Chinese President was dining with his parents, his father. So he asked, will you dine with me, Mr. President? He started singing song and yes, I will dine with you, father. So Jinping was his father. The conversation starts off. And that is the foundation of this story. I was inspired by. Jinping father kept two bowls of rice. One with egg, one without egg. Chinese are fond of rice. Although they do not have inside. So he asked, his father proposed him, what will you like to choose, the one with egg or without egg? He was very greedy, as he is today. He said, I will choose my father, the one with egg. It is very fascinating to me and I am very hungry. So he chose to eat a rice bowl with egg and gave another one without egg to his father. See, the emotions are not present in the family also. So he ate the bowl. He noticed the father's bowl has two hidden eggs at the bottom of the bowl. There were two hidden eggs at the bottom of the bowl. That depicts there could be cheating in your life. There could be betrayal. That life is not always what you see. It is not always transparent. There is lot of translucency. It is opaque, not transparent always. So, for the second time he ate, another day father asked, with egg or without egg? He said, this time father, without egg. They may be too hidden at the bottom. Another conspiracy. There were no bottom two eggs. Now he was surprised. It is like he is playing anti-China against him. So that was the political. Sorry, political. So he realized, father, you are betraying. Once you kept two at the bottom, and this day you are not. You are very showing. You are showing the character of the life. Sometimes brave, sometimes partisan. You are very true. So he said, son, it is not always what you have experienced you will do. It is not machine learning. You can face new thing. You have to be reinforcing yourself. So the next day, he noticed, again, there were two bowls. And he said to him, what will you choose? He chose the one what father will not choose. He said, my father, you choose first, then I will. And then he got more eggs than him. So the story is, respect your elders, make them happy, and the happiness will return to you automatically. Don't see always the economic prospect of choosing your decision. So these are the two stories that I was inspired by personally. And I will just say, you never win the silver. You always lose the gold. So, thank you.